It's no mean feat to keep 92,000 pounds of airplane aloft, not to mention another 59,000 pounds of passengers, fuel, and cargo. So how does a jet, with walls only a fraction of an inch thin, cope with the extreme forces it encounters in the sky? Partly, it's down to the materials of which it's made. And if you're traveling on a plane manufactured in the last few years, it might be built largely of a radical new kind of material. A material with some extraordinary properties. It's led to the biggest change in aviation design since aluminum replaced wooden planes back in the 1920s. And it's enabling the construction of a new generation of jets. One of the first was the Boeing 787, aka the Dreamliner. With this aircraft, it's not about the size, it's all about the weight. And the material that's made it possible is carbon composite, an ingenious blend of carbon fiber and plastic. Kim Pastega is responsible for Dreamliner production and knows what a revolution it represents.
Well, I've got a piece of aluminum here, which is, of course, what we traditionally have manufactured airplanes with, and a piece of our composite structure here. Well, first of all, one of the huge differences you'd be able to feel if you were holding them is just the weight between the two. It's a massive difference in terms of how the airplane performs with fuel. Maybe to give you some idea, we've got now over 300 airplanes flying in service. We've been in service since the end of 2011, and in just those short, you know, 3.5-4 years, we've already saved over 5 billion pounds of fuel with our 787 fleet. That's 20 to 25% more fuel efficient than the airplanes that it's replacing.